I'm going to get size for my first bow ever here at Archery Country. I'm super excited and pumped about this because I'm going to be taking a bow provider course this weekend with Sheepdog Response, and they teamed up with Archery Country. So I'm gonna go get fitted. And if you guys have been following me, I've been really sinking my teeth into hunting. I absolutely love it. I've been rifle hunting, and so I really want to try to do bow hunting. As a beginner and a first-time bow hunter, I'm a little nervous. And so Archery Country came highly recommended to get fitted, get sized, because they are just passionate about the community. They have tons of community events, which I'm super excited to explore and, again, sink my teeth in. And, you know, from target practice to just events with like-minded people. So what a cool thing they have going on here. So very excited, so come with me. Whee, hello.
How's it going?
It's good, how are you guys? Hi.
All right, so we're gonna start with the mission here. Yes. We're gonna get you roughed up on draw length, draw weight, and then we'll set up that Matthews there. So we're gonna put this guy on. This is a safety release, right? So just like dry firing, we don't want to do it.
Right.
This one lets us draw it back without an arrow, and we can't fire it because that trigger is pinned.
Okay.
Right? So we're gonna put this on your right hand, snug like a belt or watch. Doesn't have to be super tight. Yeah,
cool.
That's about right. So when you hold it, I like to put my thumb 180 degrees from that trigger. There you go. And then your only safety, right? Safety, fire.
Okay.
Right? It's not like a gun. That's our only safety.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so when we draw back, we need anchor points, right? Our first anchor point is gonna be hand against your face.
Okay.
I like to put my thumb underneath my jaw, kind of hook on the corner of my jaw. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people like to put that knuckle under their ear. Mm. It's about the same spot for me. Yeah. Yeah, you'll figure that one out.
Okay.
Right? That one's easy. The next one, very tip of your nose. On the string.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna hold that bow up. I'm gonna draw back. I want it to come straight to me, right? Everything's coming right to me, which, you know, what most people do is they draw back and pull their chin down, right? So instead of doing that, move the bow up.
Okay.
Like, I'm really looking for that string just to come right to you.
Okay. Now that I know it a little bit better. So here.
There you go. A little bend right here. There you go. Okay, you can let down.
Okay.
Right, let's talk about how to hold the bow.
Okay. Right.
Easy way, what I like to do, tell people, just put one, two, three fingers flat on the front right there. Right. Really what we're trying to do is put the grip down the pad of our thumb, not the palm of our hand.
Sure.
Right? So think about, hey, deer, stop. Right in that V, and you're gonna take that grip. Go right in the V, slide up, one, two, three. You can maybe do a pinky, generally no pinky.
So we're here, so then if I'm here and
right on
here.
The front, there you go, so get your finger there.
Oh, so there's, so the three is the index, middle, and then the ring.
Mm-hmm. And then you can tuck your pinky, there you go.
I was like, what do I do with that pinky?
Yeah, or shoot fancy.
What's fancy like this?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Need a cup of tea. Okay.
That's pretty good.
So now you're undoing the pin, right?
Yeah. Okay. So I just shortened it a little bit.
Okay.
So the trigger's really light right now, but once we're at full draw and pressure on it, it's quite a bit heavier.
So this can just be adjusted based off of the type of
trigger, long fingers, yeah.
Heavy you are. Okay.
Yeah, just depending on how big your hands are and how your bow's set up.
Right.
Everyone's different.
Okay.
All right, so we're gonna load our arrow with the whisker biscuit. We're gonna drop it in.
So do this?
Yep.
Okay.
And then we want the white vein up, and then you always wanna hear this sound, right?
Okay.
The knock on the string. That one didn't do it very loud. So go ahead and grab your bow.
So white vein up means why the white vein?
For clearance on the rest, right? So on this rest, those black bristles are supporting the arrow, and the brown ones are for the veins to go through. They're a little bit thinner, right?
Okay.
Or easier to pass through. So that's what's happening there.
Got it.
So hook on your trigger, push it forward.
Okay.
Perfect. We don't have any sights. I'm gonna help you aim, right? It's pretty close.
Okay.
I have confident you can hit that. There you go.
It's a little different when you have an arrow in here.
I know.
All right, so just, draw back.
Yep, just back to your nose. There you go, aim lower. Lower, okay. a little bit more.
So am I aiming through the whiskey biscuit?
No, your sight's gonna end up being about right there, right?
Okay.
So touch your nose, there you go. And then aim it like a foot lower. There you go, all right, go ahead and find your trigger. There you go, go in front of it. There you go, start squeezing. But everyone starts out pretty tense.
Yeah.
And then we relax, right? So once we relax, then it's easy to say, hey, let's change this draw length, let's move your peep sight.
Okay. So the goal here is in this, we're not worried about aiming, we're just worried about how it feels to draw and shoot.
I'm looking for draw length, right?
Okay.
I want to get a draw length that we're happy with.
Okay.
And then, you know, move forward with building out the other bow.
Okay.
Yep, go ahead.
And then slowly?
Yep. All right, so let me go ahead and shorten that draw.
Okay, am I squeezing it?
A little bit, like I think you might be collapsing just a little bit, which is pretty common. Let's say you can, with fatigue, it's gonna raise up. Nothing you can do about that other than practice. I think you're letting it collapse backwards.
Mm-hmm.
You can roll it forward, don't see that too much. And then you can also just kind of extend. We don't want to do that either. I don't see you doing that.
Okay.
But letting it collapse is pretty common, especially with ladies. A couple other things with ladies too are hips, right? If you're my target, ladies want to face the target and shoot like this,
mm-hmm.
which is quite awkward.
I see.
So think about like pointing hips towards that target, and it becomes a lot more comfortable. And you may notice after a round, you start opening up towards your target and things get weird.
Okay. All right, so this is an inch shorter.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see if it feels any better. Let's clip this. Okay, so we're in here like this. Slight bend, relax, draw back.
Push that bow out just a little bit.
Like my body or?
No, just your shoulder. Yep, stand up tall, straight. Dip your nose. That looks a lot better. Bring this hand up. There you go. That's a lot better. Okay, go ahead, whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Bring that rear hand up into your, yep, there you go. That looks really good.
Great.
One thing I'm seeing that I really like is that string. Tip your nose. We're getting corner of the mouth. I don't know if you can feel that.
Mm-mm.
And then you got your hand. So you got one, two, three things telling you you're in the right spot.
Mm.
Then we'll put the peep sight in. You'll have four things telling you you're where you need to be.
Cool.
How do you feel on accessories? Do you want to go like entry, middle, full send?
I love a good full send,
good.
I'll be honest
yeah.
with you.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm
You
don't
buy once, cry once?
Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
Yeah, it works well in here
yeah.
With most things, right?
Yeah.
Like sights, that's the one thing I'm gonna tell you, you're probably gonna buy a couple times.
Okay.
You don't know what you like. There's a ton of different styles. We'll burn that bridge when we get there.
Okay.
I did that one last because it's the hardest.
Yeah.
Of just the R2, which mounts up the same on that dovetail on the back of the riser rather than this guy that mounts to the side of the riser.
Mm.
So it's a little more streamlined, lets you run that quiver in a little bit closer,
okay.
a little bit better balance. It's a little bit more secure as well. So
the quiver meaning me quivering or
no,
like
the quiver that holds your arrows.
Oh, okay.
So it'll
Got
sit
it.
Closer to the bow
okay.
since we have that bracket out of the way.
Okay. Yeah. I like that because then it mm-hmm. feels like it's more
in line.
In line. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
This one's my favorite because it's everything this one has plus micro adjustment.
Micro adjustment from a what perspective?
So we can move the rest up or down or left and right very precisely, mm-hmm. right? So instead of on this guy, we're going to loosen a screw and try to shimmy it over.
Okay.
This one, I can loosen it, click, 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 and it moves over very precisely.
All right.
So quivers. That's something I tell people you don't have to have today, unless you're hunting this weekend. You don't have to have one, right?
But I am hunting this weekend.
Okay, then you probably want one.
Sheepdog response, bow provider, bow provider course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Heck yeah. Cool. So we got a pretty wide range of price here, you know, $40 to $250. The difference is if you're truck to tree stand, you know, if you're going a couple hundred yards, you don't need a crazy nice quiver, because when you get there, the first thing you're going to do is take it off and set it down, right? It's just transportation.
Okay.
If you're putting miles down, if you're spending a week out somewhere hunting, then it's really nice to have a good quiver that's going to hold the arrows well. It's not going to come loose, not going to rattle. And that's where it's worth paying, you know, $200 for a quiver, right? This one's my favorite, the Quivalizer. The Hoyt and the Matthews quivers are great. The G5 for $55, it's really hard to beat. So, all right, so we got quite a few different styles. We got different options. How many pins? How do you want it to operate? Do you want fixed pins as far as no adjustments on the fly? It's just 20 through 60 or 20 through 40, and that's it, right? You set your pins and that's it. Versus a sliding sight, we're gonna have, like on this guy, we got two pins, mm-hmm. and then we're gonna have a tape around here. And so we'll dial, the sight will move up and down for every yard.
Okay.
So if you wanna shoot 50 yards, you dial to 50.
So that's what a pin is too, these, or the—
Say what?
What's a pin exactly?
So those are your pins, the red and the green.
Okay.
That's how you're gonna aim.
Yep.
And those are gonna correlate to a tape on this side that's gonna be your yardage.
Okay.
Right, and those two green pointers right there, gonna correlate to those two pins.
Okay.
Right? And then like on this guy, mm-hmm. got three pins,
mm-hmm.
three pointers.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So 20, 30, 40. And then you can dial and so on. Sights are probably the one thing you're gonna buy twice.
I see.
Or that you might buy twice, right? Because it's hard to say, what do you like? What do you want? What works for you in the field?
Mm-hmm.
Like I know for me, I have a 7-pin sight as well as my Garmin. And most people are like, oh, you're crazy. 7 pins, like that's too much. I'm gonna mess up.
Sure.
It's like, well, for me, I don't wanna have to range and dial and let down. I'd rather be able to make that adjustments at full draw.
Mm.
So to me, that works better.
Okay.
I feel like I'm the 1 out of 10, whereas everyone else is like, nah, you're crazy.
Yeah.
I'd rather do a single pin. So
okay.
To each his own, right?
Sure. I would approach this as more as like baby steps.
Go simple.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I agree. Okay. It's also a big difference in weight. Like you felt how heavy that sight was on my bow, right? So the difference in weight between something like that and something like this is pretty big, right?
That's great to know, yeah.
All right, I got a lot of arrows. I got more around the corner. This is a tough one. There's
so many.
There's so many, right? So just like a couple of, I don't know, rules of thumb, right? So what I see is, you know, bigger diameter arrows, more durable, maybe easier to tune, easier to work with, less expensive, right? Versus smaller diameter arrows, more performance, as in like more penetration, less wind drift. Maybe they're a little bit more fragile, maybe they break a little bit easier, and more expensive, right? So something in the middle would be like a 5mm. The Easton Axis line is probably one of my favorite lines. They have the Sport, which is a little bit less expensive, not quite as straight. I think this is a good arrow to get into hunting or get into shooting.
Cool.
And then you can upgrade out of it, right? So you can start with these and then get to the regular axis or the match grade axis. And so what we do is we look at the energy of the bow. So how fast is it essentially? What's the draw length? What's the draw weight? And we're gonna say, what's gonna be the most appropriate arrow based on the output of that bow, right?
What's the life of these typically? And I mean, if you take care of them, can it last forever?
Yeah, essentially.
Okay. So then you kill something. I mean, I guess, again, being new here, you just whoop, take it out and then you get your arrow back. Yeah?
Yeah, I think a lot of people, like if I shot an animal or like especially a deer with it, I kind of retire the arrow. It's like, it did its job, it served me well. I'm gonna go put it in the bin,
okay,
right?
This is the exciting part. Well, all of it is. Anything new, learning, all the things. But now we're going to put together the actual piece, bow, for my draw specific, right? For me, just whatever, the way I shoot, the way I draw, and yeah, this is the exciting part. What are we doing here first?
So I'm gonna put the rest on. Get it cleaned up.
Okay, so how often does one need to clean? So, you know, typically after shooting, you wanna wipe off your gun type of thing. So what, how does that translate to?
So, archery? I guess pretty similar to a gun. Like, let's say we're in somewhere riding in a Can-Am and it's just caked in dust, right? I want to get all that dust off, and I'll probably use like a brush and compressed air. Mm-hmm. And that's usually all I do. Strings look good. Maybe we can consider it next year.
Yeah, like
paper tuning.
You'll probably see from, you know, I guess just when you do go to tune it or anything, like how I'm shooting and what potentially I need to either upgrade to or just transition to or change.
So never hunting to wanting to hunt with a bow. How do you get there?
I guess I just...
Through nutrition? And
yeah, through nutrition. Yeah. I mean, coming animal-based about 4 years ago and with obviously a heavy focus on meat. Just, yeah. You know, me, my curious mind, always wanting to seek what? Answers and full circle alignment and connection. Just kind of brought me to, okay, well, if I can hunt, then, you know, this...
How did you get to animal base?
Well, I've been a martial artist and gymnast since I was five, honestly, and so just always feeling for performance, fast forward to just, you know, being very interested in nutrition, health and wellness, and helping other people and their nutrition and health journeys. Diagnosed with celiac disease, so then, you know, just even a deeper dive into what we eat and like,
right.
And all that. So again, just as a curious person, I'm really always just seeking ways to be healthier, to optimize for performance or for the sports I want to do. Mm-hmm. So it just has led me on a path of, you know, finding the diet that works for me, and this is sort of where I landed. And I love it for its simplicity's sake, and so kind of what drew me here.
You want a black D-loop, a green D-loop?
All right, so this is the bow that is all souped up now.
Yeah, we're ready to shoot it.
Okay.
We're gonna set this peep sight, double check everything. I want to show you on the QAD how to operate it, right?
Okay.
So when you draw the bow back, this cable moves down and gets pulled tight. And then when you shoot, everything moves out of the way.
Okay.
So the one thing you need to know, do not force it down. You got a paddle over here. You can push on it, lift it up, and then flick it. Dump it like a clutch, flick it, whatever makes sense. You can do it anywhere. Just don't force it down.
Okay.
It'll happen once or twice. It's fine. But if you do it every single time, it'll quit staying up.
Okay. So you have to, do you have to put it up to put the arrow in, or you put the arrow in first and then click it?
Put the arrow in first and then you load it. And that way, when you have a broadhead on, you may not be able to feed it through there.
Okay.
Let's load up an arrow and we'll shoot. There you go.
This way, trigger behind.
Money.
Hold it,
set
shoot
your grip.
Up. Then draw.
Yep, string to your nose.
Ah!
There you go. Touch your nose to that string. Can you see through that peep sight right there?
Yes.
Is it lined up around that sight right there?
Yes.
That looks pretty good. Go ahead. Okay.
Right.
All right, orange or yellow?
Okay.
Yellow?
Yeah, yellow's fine.
Okay. They all lose the same.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you cut, did you cut these arrows down for me?
For your draw length, right?
My draw length, got it.
So that Sharpie mark there is flush with the riser. So we're going about an inch in front of that riser.
100 grain tips.
Yep. Okay. It's pretty standard. You can find that anywhere in the country. I think that'd be all you need for around here.
So the grain, is it similar to the bullets too, where it's just like the caliber on it is how much an animal will go down or get injured, or what's the?
Yeah, so like that's a 100 grain tip. That's a 200 grain. I think it's a 200 grain tip.
Okay.
And so yeah, it is heavier, right? So maybe on my recurve bow, I would definitely want the heavier tip. My compound bow, I like the speed, so I'm gonna stay with the lighter tip. For yourself, let's say we're pulling 35 pounds, maybe we do wanna add a little bit of weight to the arrow, right?
All right, here we go.
All right, nothing's changed. All we're gonna do here is use the very top pin.
Okay, why the top pin?
So our top pin is gonna be our closest. As we go down in pins, then we're aiming up higher, right?
Okay.
So this one is aiming further than that one.
Got it. Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yep. Okay. Okay. This, then we do our.
Yep.
It's not stabilizer. What is it called? The shelf?
Oh, the rest.
The rest. Yeah. Then we're going to do our little trigger, clip it behind, and I can adjust my grip. This rest here, right?
Fingertips right up front. There you go.
Okay.
Think about like doing a push-up, right? If you're gonna push me, right, you're gonna kind of load up down here.
Ah,
you're not gonna, you know, push out here with your knuckles.
So. Is that about right?
Yeah, no, that looks great.
Okay, and then the
top pin.
Top pin.
Top pin in the bullseye. So focus on the target and the trigger. And squeeze. There we go.
Okay.
There we go.
Cool.
So your pin's like your speedometer.
Mm-hmm.
You don't really need it, right? The target is the road. You definitely need the road.
Okay.
Watch the road to drive, right?
Okay.
And then your gas and brake pedal is right here.
Okay. All right, let's see. This is like the fourth day I'm using my bow. What do you think, Tyler? How did I do?
It's freaking legit.
Is it?
Freaking legit. It's awesome.
It's not bad.
It's a good group, man. Check it out.
I got a grouping.
The first one, like right
before it was like, bing, bing, bing.